A lot of responder agencies have difficulty intercommunicating, especially in an incident, and they were frustrated about not being able to use internet protocol to get interconnections between their existing equipment. The Department of Interior suggested to me that maybe I could build an interface that would allow them to take their existing radio equipment and interconnect it over internet protocol.
Basically, what Ric-M does is takes the data and voice from the base station and then converts that to the internet protocol. So once it's an internet protocol, then a lot of other systems can be plugged in and be interoperable.
So you can buy base stations from three different vendors, you can buy dispatch consoles from seven different vendors, and all of them will interconnect with the Ric-M.
It doesn't matter which bandwidth you're using, you can cross band with it, you can bring multiple assets together with one device, and whatever bandwidth it is, it's all linking together.
The business model before would have been you've had to replace the entire communication system, the mobiles, the portables, the base station equipment, and the consoles. The Ric-M allows you to take a phased approach. You can replace the console subsystem, for example, by itself, and still leverage your investment in your radio infrastructure and keep it in place.
One of the challenges with urban search and rescue is we have to bring our own infrastructure with us. Part of the major advantage of having the Ric-M is you're bringing what used to be found in a dispatch console to the incident commander's fingertips. All the convenience of a console dispatcher is now readily available for the incident commander.